The List Collection app from BoostSolutions offers a simple way to roll up list items from different sites into one single view and manage them just like in the list. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use the product. Now, let's get started. Firstly, I will introduce how to add the List Collection web part to a site page. Here we are on the site page where we want to add the web part. Click Edit at the top right of the page to enter the edit mode. Hover the mouse above or below an existing web part. You will see a line with a circled plus. Click on it, and you'll see a list of web parts appear. From this list, we will select List Collection. If it doesn't show up, just type List Collection into the search box. Now the List Collection web part is successfully added on the site page. Now, let's add some lists to our web part. For this demo, we have two lists on different sites with the same columns. The first list is named PA Team Events. And the second list is named PD Team Events. On the List Collection web part, click Settings, and then Add Collection Part. First, we need to select the site where our list is located. Now, we're going to select our first list. Next, we'll select the columns we want to display on our web part. If needed, you can also edit the column names. For this demo, we're keeping the original names. Then, click OK. Now, the first list has been successfully added on the web part. We just repeat the same steps to add the second list. And now, both of two lists have been added to our web part. Next up, we're going to create a view to organize our items. Let's click Settings on our List Collection web part, then Create View. Give a name for this view, like All Events, and make it the default view. Let's set it as a public view. In the Filter section, we'll select the lists and views that we want to filter. For this demo, we'll select both of our lists. In the Columns section, we'll choose the columns we want in our view. We'll select all columns for this demo. And we can change the position of the columns by altering the column numbers. In the Edit Menu section, we'll select a column from the drop-down list. This will link the Edit Menu to the chosen column. So, we can open, edit, or delete the item via the Edit Menu. In the Group By section, we'll select a column to group the items. In this case, we'll select the Category column. And then we'll select the expanded option. We'll keep the other settings as default and click OK to save settings. Now, our new view is successfully created on the web part. As you can see, the items are now grouped by categories. Now, let's move on to managing items on the web part. Once you've added the list to the web part, you can manage the items just like you would in a regular list. To add an item, we will click the new menu and choose the desired list. Then, we'll fill in the required information in the columns and click Save. As you can see, a new item has been added to the web part. If we check the source list, we'll see that our new item has been created there too. To modify an item, we will click Edit next to the item. We will make some changes and click Save. The changes are now reflected on our web part. And if we check the source list, we'll see that the modifications have been reflected there too. We can also delete an item from the web part. We'll click Delete next to the item and confirm our decision. The item has been successfully deleted. And if we check the source list one last time, we'll see that the item has been deleted there as well. So, that's how to use the List Collection app in SharePoint Online. BoostSolutions' List Collection is available for a 30-day free trial. Just add the app to your SharePoint Online site and start exploring all its features. If you need any help, our support team is always available to assist you. We hope this tool enhances your SharePoint experience. Thank you for watching this video.